What do you make of this? You know, politics aside, I'm not going to ask you political questions, but the larger question on deplatforming people or suspending their accounts. What do you think should be the standard on this?
Look, Sanket, there is no doubt that the tweet Rahul Gandhi put out was in violation of law and it should have been removed. But locking his account permanently, it is not proportional and it is wrong. And if it is done at this scale where you're locking several accounts, I think at some way down the line we have to discuss that, is it curbing of political speech? Is it curbing of protected speech? Because see, speech by political leaders, and it has been a global norm on social media networks that political leaders, even if they speak something wrong, it has already been labeled as a protected speech and they've never been deleted. The first time it happened that a political leader was targeted for illegal speech or manipulated media or something was when Donald Trump was deplatformed. In my personal opinion, I think we should leave politics apart and ask two bigger questions. One, if you look at the statement of Twitter, it does not have any reference of violation of Juvenile Justice Act. It does not have any reference of violation of POSCO Act. It does not have any reference of letter written by a National Commission for Protection of Child Rights. It says that we are doing this because it is against our policy. What is the underlying message? Again, you can do the hell with your law. Our policies are supreme and we will decide the quantum of punishment. Why this is happening? Because if Congress party had stood by the government when Twitter was refusing to act on lawful orders of the government, or if Congress party had supported when Twitter locked down Ravi Shankar Prasad's account or Shashi Tharoor's account for violation of some random US law for a 3-year-old tweet, things would not have come to this. Because when you try and protect a private company, a foreign company, because they're targeting your political opponents, and act as if that this foreign company is a political ally which will help you raise to power.
Okay.
Then one day the hound will come to bite you. So my fundamental question, point is that Rahul Gandhi's tweet, I think what he should have done, he should have met them, but he should not have put out that photo. And if he wanted to put out a photo for a political messaging, he should have blurred the picture of parents. If he didn't do it, if he forgot, or if it was a honest mistake, he should have deleted that tweet. Even if he made that mistake and he didn't want to own up to it, Congress party further should not have aggregated the issue by tweeting thousands of pictures by official handles. And even if it has now come, we have to ask one fundamental thing. Is Twitter forcefully locking his account, or have they given him an option to delete that tweet and then they will restore his account, and Rahul Gandhi is refusing to delete that tweet?
Well, this only so this Twitter is, I think or there the is Congress a complete
lack of clarity
say.
On the part of...
Yes, there is great...
Yes, because in the case of Ravi Shankar Prasad, it was very clear that if he... Yeah, in Ravi Shankar Prasad's case, there was a message. In Tharoor Saab's case also, there was a message that you please delete this tweet, read our policy and your account will be restored.
Aparna, in an earlier broadcast, we asked you this question on how much punishment is too much punishment for the violation of the platform. Suppose if this would have happened on your platform, what would have been the ideal punishment?
Yeah, so at Koo, we behave like a social media intermediary. We do not pass judgments. We are a technology platform which is enabling freedom of expression. And that is what we have to be true towards. As soon as the platform itself starts taking judgment calls, that is when the irritation starts for the users, for everybody else. Because the question is, who are you to take this call, right? So if it were to happen on Koo, we would look at the particular piece of content that is in question. Any further action that is requested by an authorized law enforcement agency is going to be followed. Appropriate action will be taken on that piece of content. But taking away the right to freedom of expression overall and blocking an account is something that we will not do at Koo.